Hi everyone, Aryan here from the Academic Success Center, and today we're going to be going over how you can download and effectively use the Ryerson GPA grade calculator. So I'm going into my second year of accounting and finance at TRSM, but I didn't really use the GPA calculator during my first year. What I did instead was I either used my own calculator or different websites online, which were a lot more work than this GPA calculator. On top of doing everything that the websites and my own calculator could do, the GPA calculator also allows me to store all my different grades throughout the years on the very same file. So it saves me a lot of time. If you're interested in downloading the file, there will be a link in the description of this video. So make sure to check that out as well. So now that we have all of that out of the way, let's get into some of the very basic functions of the GPA calculator. So once you do download and open the file, it will take you to the instructions tab. Feel free to read the instructions on your own time, but for the purposes of this video, I'm just going to be going over three of the tabs: semester tracker, cumulative GPA, as well as tools. So let's get it started. The first tab we're going to be exploring together will be the semester tracker. As you can see, I have already put in two courses, GMS 401 and FIN 300. GMS 401 has already been completed 100%, as you can see right over there, but FIN 300 has not. So let's go through that together. As you can see, there are three columns. First is item, second is mark in percentage, and third is weight in percentage. Under item, you just put in the title of the assessment. Under mark in percentage, you put in the mark you got on that assessment. And under weight percentage, you put in the weight of that particular assignment, which you can find on the course outline. At the bottom here, you can see total completed in percentage. What that is it just adds all the different weights, and it tells you how much of the whole course you have completed to this date. At the bottom here, you will see course summary. And in there, you can see average mark in percentage, grade points, as well as letter grade. So it automatically converts your mark in percentage to grade points and letter grade, which is also a great benefit. So let's go through some of these. Let's say for quiz four, I was able to get an 88%. And it had the same weight as the other quizzes, so a weight of 5%. Press enter on that, you will see now the total completed has updated, as well as my average mark, and of course, my grade point and letter grade as well. Now, the reason you don't want to put in the weights beforehand, before you get the mark, is that if you do, so let's say my final exam is worth 40, and as soon as I press enter, it will automatically assume that I received a 0 on that. And you can see my mark, of course, went down by a lot. So that is an inaccurate representation of your mark. So make sure to not put the weights in and put the marks as well as the weights at the same time. So let's say in the remaining 40% of the course, I want to boost my grade from the 74.4% that it is now to a 77%. So let's say the final exam is worth that 40% and I want to see what I need to get on that final exam to get this target grade. To do that, we will go to the tab Tools. Once we're at Tools, you will be taken to this page. You can scroll all the way down until you see Grade Targeter. And right here, you can see automatically the two courses that are in my semester tracker are put in, GMS 401 and FIN 300. As we said, GMS 401 has already been completed, and the mark we are targeting for FIN 300 is a 77%. So what I'm gonna do is just simply type 77, press Enter, and it will tell me what I need to get. So it tells me you need to get a grade or average grade of 80.87% in the remaining 40% of the course. So now let's go back to the semester tracker. And let's say I studied a lot and I was able to get that mark. So let's say I got an 81% on my final exam. And of course, it is worth 40% of my total grade. Press enter. And you can see everything just updated. My average mark is now a 77%, which is a B plus or a 3.33. So the last tab we're going to be exploring together is the cumulative GPA tab. As you can see, I've already put in some hypothetical first year courses as well as their grade points. And if you look here, you can see that we have cumulative GPA on the left and we have cumulative GPA in brackets includes current semester on the right. So the main difference between these two is that the one on the left, without the brackets, includes only courses that are on this specific tab. So in this example, my year one courses. However, the one on the right includes anything that is on this tab, my year one courses, as well as everything I have on my semester tracker, so GMS401 and FIN 300. That is, however, if I have enabled it. So if I go ahead and disable right here, it turns red, it will no longer track that in my cumulative GPA. Now, of course, I'm going to put it back to enabled, and we're going to go to the cumulative GPA tab. And as you can see, it will update it, including the current semester. So with all that out of the way, I want to thank you for tuning in to the Academic Success Center's walkthrough of the Grade Calculator.